Sir, what is hepatitis B and what is hepatitis C?
So this hepatitis B and hepatitis C, these are two viruses, and both of these two viruses can damage the liver if it comes to our body through the blood or through the sex.
And sir, how can one get hepatitis B and C?
Yes, just now I have mentioned about these two viruses, this hepatitis B virus and hepatitis C virus. Both the viruses, they are transmitted through blood or through sex. So any body fluid, if it is coming in contact with a person who has got the virus, it can be transmitted through that one.
What are the other different mode of transmission, sir, other than these?
Yeah, if somebody has got the chance of multiple sex partners, they may have got it, then any body fluid, already I have mentioned, or suppose somebody is having done acupuncture, so that needle can be infected, it can be transmitted. Then if somebody used to do for tattoo marks and all, again, if it is infected needle, it can go. Those drug abused persons who has got the same syringe is used in drug abuse people, IV drug abuse mainly, and it can be transmitted through that. And already I have mentioned, if suppose somebody has got, suppose a mother has got hepatitis B or hepatitis C, and she has delivered a baby, so there is a chance of transmission through the blood.
Okay, sir. And so why is it important to treat hepatitis B and hepatitis C?
Yes, hepatitis B and hepatitis C, these are two viruses that can cause long-term damage to the liver. So initially it may come to our body through the blood. After that, it will go to the liver and gradually it will damage the liver, leading to chronic hepatitis. After that, it will go to cirrhosis of the liver. Then it can ultimately lead to hepatocellular carcinoma, liver failure, or it can lead to death.
And sir, who are at the risk for this hepatitis B or hepatitis C?
Yeah, those people who have got multiple sex partners, they are at risk. Health professional, because the health professional, including the doctors, sisters, any medical staff, they used to handle the patients with hepatitis B or hepatitis C, they are prone. Then, already I have mentioned, any child or kid born to hepatitis B or hepatitis C positive mother, they have got the chance.
Sir, is there any
symptoms? And very important thing about the drug abuser, already I have mentioned about the IV drug abuser. So those who have got the habit of taking IV drug, they usually share the needle and they have got the highest chance, mainly in case of hepatitis C. It can also be transmitted in hepatitis B again.
Okay, sir. Sir, is there any common symptoms that I can come to know that I'm infected with hepatitis B or hepatitis C?
Usually no, because there are other viruses also which can lead to liver damage, and that is hepatitis A virus, hepatitis E virus. So we cannot distinguish which virus is causing the jaundice. If initially there is jaundice, there will be nausea, there will be vomiting, if it is an acute case. But most of the cases, we may not see anything. It may be a silent disease. So if it is acute case, yes, there will be jaundice, there will be fever, there will be nausea, there will be vomiting. And if you check the virus in the blood, then you can get it, whether it is B virus or whether it is C virus, or he has got or she has got whether it is A virus or E virus. But if it is a silent one, so after suddenly, suppose somebody has gone for blood donation, accidentally, or suppose for some other reason he has checked the blood, so suddenly it is an accidental detection of hepatitis B or hepatitis C, or suppose the patient is already having the chronic hepatitis symptom or cirrhosis of the liver where there is ascites, blood vomiting, leg edema, he has checked for the cause of the liver failure, so then you can get the virus. Only point is you have to check the blood or B virus or C virus, then only you can get the diagnosis of hepatitis B or hepatitis C. Simply from symptoms, it is not possible to get the diagnosis properly.
Okay, sir. And sir, what precautions I can take to prevent hepatitis B or hepatitis C virus?
Yeah, precaution for hepatitis B, it is very good that we have got a vaccine against the virus. So patient can, or other people, they can take the vaccine. Three doses have to be given. Then again, if the health professional people, they have to always be careful when they are dealing with a patient having the virus B or having the virus C. Then again, suppose somebody has got the virus in the family, either B or C, their family members should be very much careful. They should not share the same toothbrush, razor in the family, this is a seizure. So they should not share with the patient. It is not transmitted by food or transmitted by any other oral route. So that's why they should be careful so that there is no touch of the blood with the patients of hepatitis B or hepatitis C virus.
But sir, there is no vaccination for hepatitis C?
There is no vaccination against the hepatitis C virus, so that's why there are a lot of research going on. Probably in the near future, there may be a vaccine, but at the moment there is no chance of any vaccination against hepatitis C virus.
Sir, if I have got vaccinated for hepatitis B virus, am I guaranteed that I will not be getting infection?
Yeah, but for that matter, you have to check the titer, antibody titer, whether the vaccination is very much effective one or not. So you have to check the blood after some time, after the full dose of the vaccination. Then only you can get that if it is a sufficient one, then there is 100% guarantee that you will not get the virus again.
Okay, sir, is there any cure for this hepatitis B or hepatitis C virus?
For hepatitis B virus, till today it is not cured. We have a lot of medication nowadays, oral tablets or injectable form of the different molecules are there, so it can be used and it can be well controlled, but no cure. For hepatitis C virus, most of the time it can be cured even, because we have got a lot of good medication, tablet form also is coming up nowadays. And there are a lot of hopes about newer, very good medications are coming up for hepatitis C virus. But all the cases may not be successful, but there is a good chance in future for hepatitis C patients.
Sir, what advice you give for the patient infected with hepatitis B or C virus for further damage of their liver?
Yeah, they should be very much careful, already I have mentioned. Number one, they should try not to spread the disease to the other people in the family. So already I have mentioned about they should not share the same razor, same toothbrush in the family with the family members. If somebody has got any cut injury, they should cover it properly with full bandage and also that the blood is not going to touch other members of the family. Then again, they should check if suppose somebody has got the virus, they just may be a carrier state or they may have the damage of the liver, but for that matter, regularly they should be in touch with the doctor, regular visit, regular checkup. They should check for each, steps of the disease process at very frequent, say after 3 months, after 6 months, and they should be always take the consultation with an appropriate doctor consultant.
Sir, so this hepatitis B or C infected person be restricted from any work or any occupations they follow?
No, there is no data today we have got that they should be restricted or they should not take up any work. They can work, they can do their normal job, whatever they can do or they feel necessary. There is no harm of working of these patients. Those who have got the virus, they can work normally, there is no problem. Only point is, they should consult the doctor at regular intervals for precautionary measure so that they can at least avoid for further damage of the liver.
Sir, despite of hepatitis infection, I can live a normal life?
Yes, 100%. If suppose, for example, hepatitis B virus patient, most of the time they are the carrier state. So the blood will carry the virus, but it will not damage the liver. So in those patients, there is no problem at all. We don't give any treatment to the patient, not necessary to any treatment at all. Those who have got the virus, but they have already started some sort of damage to the liver also. It is a slow growing process, so that's why we used to give medication for that matter. Suppose somebody has got the hepatitis C virus again, so similar way, so it is a very slow progressive disease, so we have got the medication and you continue the medication for hepatitis C. There is a certain time, it may be depending upon the genotype, for 6 months or for 1 year. Hepatitis B virus, yes, we have the medication, and in tablet form there is no harm. You have to take the medication for long years. Till today we are not sure when to stop it, but it is a good thing that if you continue the medication, you are in a safe position.
So any final message for all the patients who are infected with this either hepatitis B or hepatitis C virus?
Yeah, my advice to all the patients who have got the virus, first of all, don't worry about your future. It is not that it is the end of the road or end of your life. So you have got very good medication nowadays, and for hepatitis B as well as for hepatitis C. So you continue the medication if necessary, because all the patients may not require even the treatment. Only observation and consultation is required. And if necessary also, these medications are very good, safe, and you can continue the medication and you can live a normal life.